Welcome again to this third video of this series on debugging some of the biggest myths in the health industry regarding health. Today I'm going to be talking to you about why sleep, actually why we need less sleep, and the more we sleep the worse it is for our health. Again, I'm repeating that we need less sleep actually, and not necessarily during the night. It took me many years to get to this, and even the most respected schools out there and organizations, they're teaching about minimum of 8 hours of sleep, 7 to 9 hours of sleep. Plus, some of them they recommend a siesta. But actually, if you think, look, a baby, a healthy baby sleeps, drinks, eats, goes to the toilet on demand, as it feels like. Now, if you become a robot to sleep, drink, eat, doing things the same time, that means you start getting addicted, because if you break your routine, then you will not feel well. So this is not a sign of health. Although you're feeling happy and well because you're having a routine. Now, with the sleep, let me explain you a couple of basic things. Please pay attention, maybe even take a pen and write it down, because it took me many years and a lot of time and money invested on different courses to get to the bottom of this. Now, everyone got a pen? I can't see you, but I presume you have it. First of all, we don't need to have any habits. So if someone tells you need to sleep all the time at this time, no. It's good to have a habit, but you need to break it from time to time so you're not addicted to that. So what is the best time to sleep? Well, between 11 and 1 o'clock in the evening, we have the gallbladder, it's cleansing, and between 1 and between 1 till 3 o'clock you have the liver cleansing. So these hours it's good to be in bed, so we allow the body to rest. Now, a lot of you, you're probably sleeping about 10 o'clock and waking up 6-7 o'clock. Well, the tricky bit is that between 3 to 5 o'clock is the lung meridian, which this it needs to be active at that time. So 3 till 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock, actually, in an extra hour, it's actually the worst hours that we can sleep. I said, what? This is the worst hours that we can sleep? Yes, and let me explain. I know it sounds strange, but again, I've been walking the talk, I've been doing these things, and also a lot of my clients, and especially with serious health problems, and some who wanted to take their health to the next level, start applying some of these techniques and sorted a lot of their health issues. So, if 150 years ago, before we have the lights, it was very common, before we have the electricity, it was very common people to wake up at 3 o'clock, cook something, do meditation, making love, some of them, and then go back to bed about 5-6 o'clock in the morning, or just take a nap during the day later on. The reason being is they knew that if they sleep between 3 and 5 o'clock, because the lung meridian is active, then they will start hyperventilating. This is something that the yogis, even in other religions, in Christianity, they knew. That's why they get up 3 o'clock, around 3 o'clock, and they meditate or pray. Years ago, I was attending some meditation classes with a lovely organization, and they were encouraging us to get up 3 o'clock, meditate for half an hour, and then go back to bed. I thought, that's crazy. Why we should do that? Now, obviously, they have this information from their teachers and yogis. They didn't know why, but they knew that have an impact on the way we feel and the way we think, because we were stopping the hyperventilation process. So That's all. Basically, you need to break your sleep. You don't, shouldn't have any specific patterns. And sometimes, yes, you can even sleep on the chair. Anything to make the body uncomfortable from time to time, so you're breaking the routines. Once you learn how to do the breathing exercises, it's not enough just to stay awake. You need to do something to give more energy to yourself, to oxygenate yourself. Once you start applying these exercises, which I'm going to be teaching in a week, then you will be able to stay awake all night and without feeling tired to sleep. Obviously, your mind, it's going to be telling you, oh, I need to sleep, I need to sleep. Although you're not feeling sleepy, so unless you feel sleepy, don't go to sleep. The best way to try that is going to be obviously a weekend, so you don't have to go to work. And again, you need some guidance and supervision to achieve that. But at least you know that sleeping many hours is making you more tired because it's forcing you to hyperventilate. And if you're not sure what is hyperventilation, just go back and look on the first video. All the links they will be under this video. So on that note, I'll see you on the next video, the fourth one, which actually I'm gonna debunk in another myth, which is that we need to drink lots of water. Well, it depends. We might need to drink one glass of water if we're oxygenated properly. So until the next video, which will be tomorrow, enjoy the rest of the day. And please feel free to share, comment on the video. Feel free to share it with friends and relatives, but don't put it publicly on the social media. As I said, this is some promo videos to prepare some of my clients who's joining me next week.